गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ क्लास टू, वी हैव कम बैक टू आवर मॉरल साइंस क्लास। वी हैव ऑलरेडी कंप्लीटेड द चैप्टर क्लीन अप क्रो, चैप्टर नंबर 4। जस्ट रीड द स्टोरी दैट डे। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस द क्वेश्चंस। बिफोर सेंडिंग क्वेश्चंस आई वांट टू डिस्कस इट। हु वोक अप व्हेन अ फ्रूट फेल ऑन हिज head? A sleeping jackal woke up when a half-eaten mango fell on his head. What happened when the crow stopped eating and walking? When the crow sat alone and stopped eating and walking for days, the forest soon became dirty with rotting fruits and garbage, and animals fell sick. Why did the animals thank the crow? When the wisest elephant had understood the helping work of the crow to make the forest clean, then he went to the crow and encouraged him. With the elephant, all the animals also praised and thanked the crow for his work. Was it only the crow's job to keep the forest clean? Not only it was the crow's job to keep the forest clean, but also it was the duty of the all inhabitants of the forests. Fill in the blanks. Candy, the clean robot, hates dirty and germs. Fill in the blanks to show what she does. Candy always washes her hands with soap before eating. What are given here? Dustbin, germs, handkerchief, teeth and soap. Okay. Candy always washes her hands with soap before eating. She throws empty wrappers and waste paper in the dustbin. She covers her mouth with a handkerchief when she sneezes. Yes, we also do this, isn't it? Yes. Candy knows that if you sneeze without covering your mouth, you can spread germs to others. Candy cleans her teeth with a brush and toothpaste twice a day. Yes, you have to do it. To clean your teeth, you have to brush your teeth twice a day before going to bed and at the morning time, isn't it? Write 3 lines about how you keep the classroom clean. Yes, I'm writing 3 sentences for you. How do you keep the classroom clean? We must throw papers, pencil, savings in the dustbin. We must arrange and keep our books on the bookshelves or desks. We must keep the duster and blackboard clean. Yes, we have completed the questions from this chapter. Here is an interesting thing. Things to do. Paste some flowers in the vase to make it look beautiful. Use waste material like pencil, savings, buttons, color papers. Yes, you can use these things and make it colorful. You can do it yourself with the help of pencil, savings. You can make flowers here and a button you put inside the pencil, savings, and use color papers to make the leaves of the flowers, and also draw some pictures on the vase. It will look nice. Not now. In your off time you will do it. Don't do it now. Okay? Now we are coming to the next chapter. Today just we go through the chapter. Don't do any questions here. The Angry Ogre. Once upon a time there was an angry ogre. He was angry noon and night, so his friends named him Grr. He was angry in the morning. He was angry late at night. He was angry if things went wrong, and also things went right. Never did girl smile, and he wrote over an angry scroll. Instead of speaking softly, he let out angry howl. He shouted at his friends and stomped his feet in rage. He tore up all his books, page after page. He threw his toys around on every angry day and tore his buttons off when he couldn't have his way. He had no friend to play with. He had no pet that he loved. He was just an angry ogre who pushed around and sobbed. His head hurt with anger. His eyes were turning red, but anger did not leave him, even when he went to bed. He let anger own him, and now this awful pest was living right inside him, like a bird in a nest. Girl began to tire, and his head began to pain. His throat hurt with shouting again and again and again. So what do we learn from this chapter? Here is a giant whose name is Gar. So ogre means giant. Howl means a long, sad and angry sound. Awful means very bad. Awful means very bad. Scowl, an angry look. Sob, puss, pest. Person or thing you do not like. There was a angry ogre. There was a giant who was very angry. He was angry always. From the morning till night, he was always angry. His name was Grr. So when the things is wrong, he was angry. When the things is right, then he also angry. So he never smiled. He always wearing an angry look. He never can speak. He couldn't speak softly. Always howling, then with his angry sound. He shouted to his friends when he was become very annoyed. He stomped his feet on the ground. He tore off his books and copies. He threw toys around, and he has no time to put his button off. He just tore it out. He just tore off his buttons when he was become very much angry. He had no friends to play with him. He had no pet to love. He was just always pushing everything around. With his anger, his head always paining, his eyes became red, but he could not leave his anger from him. So anger was the boss of this ogre. It was like a awful pest. Pest means which is a person or thing we do not like. He could not leave this pest from him. They were living in his head like a nest full of body. He began to tire, and his head began to pain, and his throats also became hurt with his shouting. He was always shouting. For that reason, his throat became hurt. So we have to be careful. We must not be angry so much. Yes, it is very bad thing. We must always listen to our parents. Yes, our mother is the best friend. She always guides us in proper way. So we must follow her words, and every elders of our house also guides the every elders of the house also guide the children how to behave in the home and the outside. So what do we learn from this chapter? We learn we all feel angry sometimes, but we must try to stop being angry. Anger makes everyone unhappy. Okay, so remember, you should not be angry very much. Okay, just always be calm. Yes, thank you.